ahead of Super Mario Bros. Wonder, the new side-scroller psychedelic game Nintendo has been making since earlier this year, we came across not one, but actually a few trailers showcasing the gameplay, the physical editions you can pick up, and some new twists that's been added to the new entry. Just take a look. Super Mario Bros. Wonder is releasing October 20th this year for the Nintendo Switch alone.
Here's Tim. He's my partner at the moment. For some reason, Tim can understand what I'm saying, even though he's human. And this guy right here is Harry. He's Tim's dad, if you can believe it.
Originally released on the Nintendo 3DS first, at number 2, we have Detective Pikachu Returns, this time acting as a sequel to the first game, the almost live-action anime detective adventure game, and now it's going to be coming to the Nintendo Switch only October 6th this year, so keep it in mind. Oh, by the way, this game is also available to pre-order right now.
Now, let me give you the gist of what me and Tim do. Whenever an incident occurs, Tim talks to the people, I talk to the Pokémon. And we work together using our case notebook to deduce what happened. When investigating a scene, we're total pros at finding everything. But even pros gotta take it easy every so often. You can count on us to solve even the toughest cases in a flash. Oh, right! Sometimes other Pokémon help us with our investigations. Take Rowlett, for instance. She can track down suspects with her sensitive nose. And Darmanitan here packs a pulverizing punch. All kinds of Pokémon lend us a hand. Oh, how could I forget the Hi Hat Cafe? It's a famous coffee house in Rhyme City, and I'm their best customer. Oh, that first cup in the morning really hits the spot.
Wake up, Mr. Wayne. We have much to discuss. I want you to know the fear that is coming.
Nintendo just came out and announced that a Batman package going by Arkham Trilogy is coming over to the Hybrid console by the end of the year. That would be Arkham Asylum, Arkham City, and Arkham Knights, along with all the DLCs that was released for the game, period. Previously, the news was only just a post, but we got some trailer for it, an update, and that the game is now releasing October 13, in addition to this.
I will command forces beyond your comprehension.
I've waited long enough. Batman dies tonight.
This place is dangerous. I like it. Gotham would be ours.
Over my dead body.
I believe that was the idea.
Moving on to number 4, it's the one and only Front Mission 2 Remake's Western Debut, which is now set to come out October 5 with a 4 months delay as opposed to previously announced June release. A new trailer over here, in case you missed it, and this is one of Square Enix's best turn-based tactics, Final Fantasy inspired and playstyle story-wise, revolving around a near future political conflict between human piloted mechanisms. Check it out. Metal Gear 1 and 2 Solid Snake are coming to the Hybrid console October 24 this year. This collection will cost you about $60, and to accompany the good news, Konami released a new trailer for it too. And not only that, you will play both games on the go this time. The gameplay is actually compromised with a smoother overall quality and some graphical improvements as well. Check it out. Number 6 is the one open world, actually the biggest open world RPG first person shooter that's coming to the console, Borderlands 3. This game is coming to the hybrid console on October 6th with all of its DLCs and some gameplay improvements on Switch. It will actually be roughly 15 GB, and the whole thing will be about $40. Anyway, Borderlands 3 is literally the biggest game in scale releasing on the hybrid console ever. Superstars, on the other hand, another Sonic 2D adventure Sega that's making for over 2 years now, to be an all-new take on the classic 2D Sonic fast-paced or high-speed action platforming, is now coming out for the Nintendo Switch, PCs, and other consoles on September 17 this year. This game was announced earlier this year, previously said to be coming out November, but now a month earlier. Chunkfish and Robotality just gave us an update on their upcoming strategy sequel game Wargroove 2, which will now be coming out October 5. The sequel will actually have a roguelike mode, a level editor, better graphics, a massive pool of options for the editor, a campaign, some oddly satisfying, good-looking Fire Emblem-inspired action, and real good art design as well. Check it out, in case you missed it. Cry Machina, on the other hand, is a action RPG where some future version of Earth, mechanical people, I mean technically girls, have been surviving in a post-apocalyptic era to become real humans. Now, nobody knows why girls, but I believe it's actually inspired from the Niki games, the online ones, and it has a somewhat similar story to Pinocchio. Cry Machina is due out October 24 this year for PCs, PlayStation consoles, and also the Nintendo Switch.
にかっこいい生き様じゃないか。天使。 違うよ。私はエノア。機械。
選ばれし者。
本物の人間になる存在という意味だと私は信じてる。生きて、エーベン。人間として。
Got movement.
Shh, quietly.
Me? Quiet?
Don't worry. Quiet time never lasts long.
Have a look, see, little buddy.
Happier now, then?
Oh yeah, rock and roll!
This is the most anticipated game in its own genre since announcement. We've got over here at number 10, Endless Dungeon. The second title in the Endless universe, I'm pretty sure most of you are already familiar with as the Dungeon of the Endless. This game is a roguelike tactical action shooter, more to the point, a sort of a strategy tower defense where you have to recruit a team of heroes and fight never-ending waves of monsters. Like, you know, alien shooters. Take a look. Company the good news, we had a new trailer for it too.
Take a peek.
Friends, this guy may take a couple of tries.
Well, see you at the saloon.
Coming up behind that, we have something over here called Bang on Balls. Chronicles. This is an open-world sandbox adventure that was first launched in early access for PCs via Steam on March 3, like 2 years ago. The game is now coming back and in the making for the Nintendo Switch as a wholly compromised port this year on October 5. Here's a trailer. This game is a bouncy platformer inspired by some of the best classics, I mean taken from Mario, Sonic, and even the Crash games. Take a look. About a week ago, NIS America released another trailer for Disgaea 7. Now, it finally came out and announced a release date of October 3rd for the game, coming to PCs, Switch, and also the PlayStation consoles. If you are new here, just keep in mind, this is a series of strategy or turn-based RPGs that go back to more than 20 years since the original game. It's a bit of a comedy themed, but the story and pace is some of the most addicting in this particular genre, especially on the go.
Iconic vehicles from the Hot Wheels world. Yeah, the ones you've always wanted. Excited? Wait until you see these.
If you didn't know this already, the Fast and Furious world is meeting Hot Wheels Unleashed series in the new game that the company's been making Hot Wheels to turbocharge when the game releases October 19 this year. PCs, consoles, and also the Nintendo Switch too. Anyway, accompanying the good words, we got a new trailer. In addition to the promise of 40 tracks, 70 cars, and a lot of different licensed DLCs that's going to be released later down the line. Take a look.
To go into corners like a pro, heavy duty, massive and stronger, and off-road. Well, you get it. Oh yes, you heard it right, off-road. Because even the terrains are new. And now each surface will have a different impact on the handling of your vehicle. So be strategic and take advantage of their abilities to master every terrain and show off your skills racing through exciting playgrounds. Take this quiet suburban house, for example. Not so quiet anymore, huh?
Marvelous and Exceed Games just went on and revealed their new IP. I mean, this has been a month now, but they re-revealed it, something called Silent Hope. This is an asymmetric action RPG, tad inspired by Rune Factory, which was teased earlier in the year, and it just went on and received an upbeat trailer. Which is, in addition to Japan's, the game's now releasing worldwide October 3 this year for Switch, PCs, and other consoles, also available to be purchased for the price of $40. Inescapable No Rules, No Escape, the game, however, is an adventure death game, as its developers stated, a story-heavy choice-based and a narrative here, about some island resort where you've been kidnapped and forced to participate in a really twisted reality show with 10 other strangers, where at the end of the stay, they'll each receive $1 million. Anyway, it's kind of like the Nonori games in premise. The game is coming out October 19 for the Nintendo Switch and other consoles as well. Island Rise of Kong will be available on the Nintendo Switch, PCs, and other consoles October 17 this year. This is a third-person action adventure, as developers promise, delivering a thrilling and immersive experience combining action and storytelling in a unique and captivating way. Just take a look. The game is releasing October 17 this year. Coming up behind that, we have Wild Card Football. This is an arcade action football game by Saber Interactive, the company's latest addition to the Arcade Sports Playground franchise, supposedly a much more action-oriented entry compared to its previous iterations. The game will be coming out October 10, Xbox consoles, PCs, and also the Nintendo Switch, in addition to being available to pre-order right now. And last but not least, announced December last year, we have an action roguelike brand new game over here with a new trailer, in case you missed it, a game called Hellboy Web of Wired. Previously, there was just a cinematic for the game, now we have some gameplay and a release date of October 4 this year across PCs, both generation of consoles, in addition to the Nintendo Switch. And this is how the game will eventually look.
I said stay down! And we are done!